Now, as the final step of this short training, let's look together all the configuration options which are available in DAX Studio. We have already seen some of them during each individual step, but it is still useful to look at them all together in order to have an overview of what you can configure in DAX Studio. Let's start. In order to access the options, what you need to do is just to go to File Options. You have Standard, Key Bindings, and Advanced. Let's start from the Standard and let's zoom in a bit. We have already seen some of them, so I'm gonna run quickly on them. You can configure the custom export format, that is the output of files when you redirect the output of a query. You can change the DAX formatter default style. You can change the default separator, whether you're using the US standard or other standards. You can decide whether you want clear cache as and run as a default, and if you want to show the username in the title bar or not. Regarding the editor, you can choose the font size, the font family, whether you want line numbers or not, and a lot of different details about the editing experience that happens when you work with your model. In the metadata panel, you have, again, a bit more interesting options. Whether you want a prompt before refreshing metadata or not. This happens when the database to which DAX Studio is connected happens to refresh some of the metadata. By default, DAX Studio automatically updates its internal structures, but you might want to delay that and to get a warning that you need to confirm. In that case, you need to check it. Whether you want to detect the metadata changes automatically or not. By default, it's enabled for local connection and network connection, but it is disabled for cloud connection to avoid too much traffic over the web. Whether you want to keep the metadata search open or not, if you want the statistics in the tooltips, if you want to see hidden objects, and whether you want to sort the folder first in the metadata panel. The default settings are typically good enough for everybody. Proxy for the internet connection, how many history items you want to keep in the query history, and whether you want to show the trace timings or not. For the result, there are some settings which are useful. The automatic format result. This is useful in order to see the results of numbers automatically formatted by DAX Studio. Whether you want to, what you want to use for as the default for dates. Sometimes you are not interested in the time part of a date, so you can just put here the correct format. Whether you want to exclude or not the headers if you copy data from the grid view, which is not so useful because most of the time you will use the redirection of the output to the file that you want to have, and the size of the font, the size and the family of the font for the result. Timeouts, that might only be useful if you have query that lasts for a very long time, then you can change these timeouts for the DAX formatter, for the server time events, and for the trace startup. Again, the default here is quite always good. And for the traces or not, whether you want to trace also direct query, when you connect to a database server, to a tabular servers, which are earlier than SQL Server 2017, then tracing the direct query might take a bit more resources, so you can decide whether to enable it or not. In the key bindings, you can look and you can change each key binding. You can reset everything to the default, which works fine quite always, but if you want to change anything, you can go here and just change whatever operation with the key binding. And finally, in the advanced part, you have whether you want or not to have preview features. This part is likely to change over time because, remember, DAX Studio is a tool that changes quite often. So this is the current status of DAX Studio, but being a very live project, there are, of course, new features coming not every month, but kind of. So we have seen the basic features and the most useful feature of DAX Studio. There will be more. We might need to update the training, but now it's up to you. Start using DAX Studio. It's going to be your best friend whenever you need to write DAX code, analyze performance, or learn better about anything about DAX. Enjoy DAX Studio.